Hello there, and welcome to this video. Let's see together everything you need to know to start using Apple iMovie. Leave us comments inside the video description to help us improve our future video guides for this software. Apple iMovie is one of the best software products used to create your own videos and slideshows by editing your media and adding amazing effects and transitions to these. When opening iMovie, a startup window opens, divided in three tables on top. Media is used to check your iMovie libraries, which are collections of media that share a same topic. You can create new custom libraries by right-clicking on a vacant space and going to New Event. Then, you can simply drag and drop your media directly on the open library. You can import videos, images, and also audio files. You can delete existing libraries by right-clicking on one and going to Delete Event. The Theater section is used to import, share, and playback your custom videos and projects online from any of your devices. The Projects tab lists all your iMovie projects made in order to open and edit these back again. In particular, by using the button next to each project name, you can play it, open it, edit it, and also rename and delete it. To see how to start with iMovie for the first time, let's begin with the new iMovie project. To create new projects, just click on Create New. Here, you can choose between a movie and a trailer project. A movie is used to create custom videos and slideshow from scratch, whereas a trailer starts from a ready template close to film-like videos. In this very basic beginner tutorial, we will see just the movie projects. The overall iMovie workspace is divided in three main parts: the panels, the video preview, and the overall timeline more below. Before starting with a new project, it is important to import all the media needed, such as videos, images, and audio files. From the My Media tab, you can browse inside your own personal iMovie libraries and simply drag and drop your files on the timeline below. You can also use the Audio section to browse for your own tracks from iTunes, GarageBand, or for special audio effects available on your Mac. You can also use the Import button on top in order to browse inside your Mac and pick and import your files, or even drag and drop these from an open Mac folder directly. All files imported inside the project timeline are shown as big rectangles called clips, and are all listed inside the Project Media Library under the My Media tab. Before starting to edit, it is important to know how to preview the content of your project. First of all, the clips inside the timeline offer a quick and fast preview of their respective content. Sound clips are green, with their sound waveform shown. That indicates the volume level during the time. Pictures and videos are blue, showing thumbnails representing the picture or the video frames. These also show a reserved slot that is covered by audio and sound, especially for video clips. For an overall preview on the whole project, you can use the Video Preview. Use its player below or the spacebar key to quickly play back and pause both videos and sound. Also, play back in full screen mode by using the button on the far right. As you can see, a delicate zoom on pictures is always applied by default. Especially when you're editing your project, you may need to get faster previews on it. If you hover your pointer on the timeline and move it, the video preview shows what the overall project frames look like. When your pointer goes out on the timeline, the preview shows what is under the gray playhead, that it can be fixed by clicking on the timeline. This also fixes the starting point of the preview player. Let's see how to edit and customize your iMovie project. The filled timeline below is composed by two rows filled by videos and images called video tracks, and another two or more rows used to place audio and sound files called audio tracks. Further below, there is also another row that you can use for audio files. Each clip can be moved in time by clicking and dragging it on the left or right. If you have videos with audio, you will move both, of course. In case you want to make a video and audio independent, just right-click on the clip and go to Detach Audio. At this point, video frames and audio will be two separate clips. iMovie manages your project content by using a storyboard view, where clips are linked and attached to each other. Inside the timeline, there's always a main video track, whose main clips are preceded by a dark marker, indicating that each of these clips fix the other clips in time position. In short, if the beginning of any video, image, or sound clip overlaps a main clip in time, it will be attached to such main clip, as you can see by the small links that show up. This means that if you move the main clip in time, all of the attached clips from the other tracks will also be moved in time in the same way. Also, if these clips are moved until they overlap another main clip, these will attach to this new main clip, depending on it. The two video tracks on the timeline are not exactly the same. In fact, all the clips that are placed on the first video track from the top are always shown above the clips inside the main video track. To stretch or shorten the time duration of the clips, just click and drag from their far edges. You can check the clip duration by looking at the clip corner on the left. This operation may cut some content from the video or audio clip affected. To shorten or stretch video or audio clips without cutting or looping their content, it is sufficient to change their playback speed. If you right-click on the clip and go to Show Speed Editor, a black line appears right above the clip. If you click and move the marker from the right to the left, you will increase the playback speed, as the hair icon suggests, and this will also shorten the clip duration in time without changing its content. If you stretch the clip, this will be played slower, as the turtle icon indicates. You can cut, copy, and paste a clip by clicking on it and then using Command and X, Command and C, and Command and V respectively. When you paste, the clip is placed where your pointer is. In case you want to cut just a part of the clip, just hold the R key from your keyboard and click and drag on the clip to select a portion of it. When you cut, you will affect just the part of the clip within such region. To split a clip in two, just right-click on it and go to Split. The clip is split where the gray playhead is. This just works on clips inside the main video track. Remember that, in case you make any mistake, you can go backwards by using Command and Z multiple times. There are other nice things you can make directly on each clip. When you hover over a visible clip, two markers appear on its extreme edges. If you click and drag these, you will create a fade transition, where the clip transparency changes in time in order to make it appear at the beginning and disappear at its end. This can be applied on audio clips as well, with the difference that this transition acts on the sound volume. These fast fade transitions can't be applied on main clips. For these, you have to use the Transitions tab on top. Choose the right one for you, and drag and drop it between two main clips, or at the very beginning or end. Consider that these transitions may reduce the clip's duration depending on the length of the transitions applied. That can be checked by hovering the transition symbol. Double-click on it to change it. Whereas, to change the kind of transition, just drag and drop another from the Transitions section. Even more, when you hover on an audio clip, you can click and pull up or down the black straight line you see in order to regulate its volume in a uniform way. Avoid any red waveform, since this causes sound saturation. iMovie allows you to fully edit the content of each video, image, or sound clip through several tools available right above the video preview that turn on or off depending on the clip chosen from the timeline. For example, if you select any video or image clip, you can use the color balance and color correction to correct the colors of the clip. The cropping tool to crop the clip by using the nodes in the preview. If you select a clip which is not inside the main video track, you can also use video overlay settings to adjust the way the clip must overlap on the main clip below it by regulating opacity, selecting split screen, or applying a great picture-in-picture effect, regulating the clip size through the nodes, and the clip placement by clicking and dragging it where you like. If you select audio clips or videos with audio, you can regulate sound from the other tools. Use volume to adjust the volume, the equalizer to apply audio filters, the speed tool to regulate the audio's playback speed and pitch, and use the last tool to apply filters and simple, amazing audio effects. Keep in mind that you may need to click on the checkmark button on the far right to apply the changes on some of these tools. Inside iMovie, you can also add text and titles by using the Ready Templates under the Titles tab. Choose one and drag and drop it from inside your timeline. This will create a title clip under a violet color with duration and title content on it. This piece of text can be fully edited by clicking on it and using the Title Settings tool above the video preview. Click inside to type in and edit all the text properties by using the options above. Let's see how to save your work. Your iMovie project is saved automatically. You can rename and set your project by coming to the main page of iMovie by going to the Projects button. To render the project content and obtain the final video, just go to the Share button in the top right corner. You can choose whether to render and upload it online, on a social website, or render it inside your Mac disk by going to File. In the New window, choose the video resolution, its quality, and settings. Then click on Next and choose the video name and its destination folder. The render will start on the background, and you can check its progress next to the Share button. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more free and amazing guides for Apple software.